The reason I wanted to do this vegetable trial is the lack of water worldwide and the need to have more food. So we have to work more efficient with water, and for that reason we use the water box. With the water box I have very good results planting trees in deserts, and that actually made me think of, could we repeat those results by planting vegetables with it and still using very little water? And as you see here, we have extremely good results. We have fantastic tomatoes, and also all our other vegetables are very successful. Now, of course, you have various challenges, and the most important one is that how do you bring the minerals, the food that the plants need, to the plant if you hardly use any water? Because if you use too much artificial fertilizers, then the roots will burn. Now, for that reason, we have done a lot of trials with mycorrhizae. Mycorrhizae are funguses that actually are living in the soil and help the roots to eat the minerals in a better and more efficient way. So what actually is happening is that the mycorrhizae dissolve the minerals and they give them to the plant, and the plant pays with sugars to the mycorrhizae, and this is how the humus in the soil, the percentage of it, get higher. Now, of course, it's very difficult to find which mycorrhizae you need. So in this greenhouse, we use four different types of mycorrhizae and a control group. And what happens is that the mycorrhizae dissolve the minerals in the soil so well that although we hardly have used any fertilizers, we still have a fantastic crop. And we're very proud of that. In the coming years, we're going to introduce those mycorrhizae that are necessary to have a good crop and still using almost no fertilizers. The fertilizers that we have used are actually biological fertilizers, just manure. So before planting, we have mixed a little bit of compost and manure through the soil, and then we have planted our plants on it. We didn't use artificial fertilizers, which means that you also save a lot of money because fertilizers are very expensive. So we're very happy with our results. And we hope that in the coming years we can prove that you can actually grow vegetables with little water and almost without fertilizers.
We have to cut off the leaves of the tomato plant because the leaves keep the tomato from not coloring. So when we take off the leaves, tomatoes color faster because they hang in the sun, and the hormones of the leaves producing not coloring, they are gone, so it's coloring more quickly. We cut the leaves because of the botrytis, that's a fungi, and when you break the leaf, or when you cut the leaf like this and you leave this on the plant, or you break the leaf and you make a wound like this, like this is very, very bad. The fungi is coming, botrytis, and it kills the plant because it's going into the stem of the plant and it kills the plant. So that's why we take a knife with a round blade. You can touch the tomato without damaging it. And we are doing it like this. We put the knife, we take the place where the shoots are coming out, and then we make a movement like this. And then we have a very nice wound. And we do it in the morning because when you do it in the evening, the humidity goes up and the fungi gets chance to go into the wound. So when you do it in the morning with nice weather, the wound will be dry in the evening. Every week we take 2 or 3 leaves of the plant. When you are picking tomatoes, you have to choose the tomato with medium color. Because we don't pick the vine, we pick them loose, we take the medium color. It's very important when you pick a tomato that you leave the green part of the tomato on the fruit. And you see this bubble here, this is the breaking point. Put your thumb like this and your nail against the breaking point, and you turn the fruit like this. And then the green part is sticking on the tomato.
This is the minimum color.
Greener as this is not possible.
We don't want to damage the other tomatoes. When the tomato is
going like this, it makes a hole in the other tomato. That's why we put one tomato like this and the other one we put up like this.
We've also thought about what we are going to do with the production of our project.
So every week this amount of fruits and vegetables is going to the food bank.